like the mouse movement isn't any better than the other. That's the most worst thing. Then the scholar of the team. Like, where are magnitude different from where? It's interesting that it's tilted towards us. That's an interesting
good evening. It is so nice to see all of you in the audience, and I can tell you, after 2+ years of pandemic, this just doesn't get old. It's really a thrill to be here. It's a thrill to be able to welcome parents and family and friends to our beautiful campus and to Centennial Hall for our spring concert. And we've been working hard all semester, and we are thrilled to present our program for you this evening. If I can just say just a little bit about our first piece, Mount Fuji, is a traditional Japanese folk song. Mount Fuji, the tallest mountain in Japan on the island of Honshu, is a cultural touchstone in Japan. It shows up in numerous works of Japanese art and culture, and it's considered an honor to be able to climb Mount Fuji at some point in your life. When I made this arrangement, I found the text of this folk song quite beautiful, and so I thought I would read it to you. Poking its head out over the clouds, looking down on all of the neighboring mountains, and listening to the thunder booming far below, Fuji is the greatest mountain in Japan. It towers high up in the blue skies, wearing a kimono of snow on its body. At its feet unfurls a hem of fog. Fuji is the greatest mountain in Japan. To conduct this work, I'd like to welcome to the podium our Dorothy Claiborne Fellow and wonderful colleague, Mr. Alan Branch.
Thank you.
Our next work, a sonata by Arcangelo Corelli, will feature a smaller group of our 7th and 8th graders. Arcangelo Corelli represents an important pivot point in music history because he was one of the earliest Baroque composers to focus entirely on instrumental music rather than on vocal music, which was the primary form of music at that time. And we're very pleased to present this sonata for you. Symphony is a suite by German composer Johann Fischer. Johann Fischer was a prominent German composer, and I thought this would be a great piece for us to show our development through the year. The first piece that you heard, Mount Fuji, featured a lot of playing together, really beautiful harmonization, almost like a hymn or a chorale. And this piece features quite a lot of counterpoint, a lot of individual and intricate kind of voicing. And that requires great concentration. We worked on matching our articulations, the way that we play our notes, so that we could really play beautifully together. And it is quite an accomplishment for this ensemble to play a work like this in both movements. So before we play our final piece, I just want to thank all of you parents and family members for supporting the music making of the people on stage. We couldn't do it without you. And I also want to thank our middle school faculty for supporting our Brin Symphony program. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Between Bryn Symphony and some choirs. So I thought I would share with you on our program a little bit about what you are getting ready to see and hear. The middle school, sixth grade, had a chance to observe and study the wonderful American musical, The Sound of Music, by Richard Rodgers and Oscar Hammerstein II. There's a wonderful quote by Oscar Hammerstein that says, "A song's not a song till you sing it. A bell's not a bell till you ring it. Love wasn't put in your heart to stay. Love isn't love till you give it away." I think that's very fitting and appropriate for us tonight, as we all, as performing artists, have put a lot of love into sharing with you tonight. So as we continue to set up our stage, I want you to know that we'll be hearing a medley from Cantemus, the sixth grade choir, that is from The Sound of Music. That will be their second piece. Their first piece will be a Canadian Native American folk song. We don't really know the origin, but we do have an idea of where it came from in and around Ontario in Canada, and I'm going to abandon my piano bench and let a student play tonight. That student is so Mayberry Lareris will be coming to play. We also have some soloists who will be playing on the soprano recorder. After The Land of the Silver Birch and The Sound of Music medley, you may notice a familiar Disney song. We would like for you to not remain complacent and seated very comfortably behind your mask. We want you to keep your mask on. But you may observe our wonderful Colombian American Spanish teacher, Senor Balcazar, get up and start to dance. It just might happen uncontrollably, so we give you permission to join in on the singing of We Don't Talk About Someone. Okay, ready? Thank you, sixth grade. Cantemus. Cantemus is the Latin word that means we sing. Exclamemus means we sing out. We exclaim. So from sixth grade to seventh grade, you may have noticed a little scratchy transition. I've heard a lot of talk about voice cracks. It's really fun. Middle school's awesome. By the time you get to eighth grade, you're ready to sail into ninth grade. You'll hear that in a moment. In the seventh grade, we have a wonderful piece that we want to sing for you called Bayangko. This is a Philippine folk song, and we have learned it in Tagalog. We have some very special guests with us from Philippines and also watching us online that we have prepared this for especially. So if you happen to speak Tagalog or have Filipino heritage, this is almost a national anthem for many in the Philippines.
Catch me and catch,
Islamimus. Summis Dei, our eighth grade choir. Summis Dei is Latin for "We are goddesses." And as they come, we are going to do a little switch in our program. They're going to be singing "What a Wonderful World" first, followed by "Seasons of Love."
Thank you.
eighth grade world music class has been learning drum rudiments with Mr. Branch. And they're going to be setting up to play a piece called Levitating. But I decided since Dr. Levitoff is here, we'll call it Levitoffing. It's a great piece, you might know it. And they're just going to need a moment to get set up. I want to say a word about what it's like to practice for months without a mask and to get the word that you gotta put them back on. These guys have such good attitudes. I just want to say, I mean, recognize that tonight. Thank you for persevering in the midst of all kinds of fluctuating numbers. We are not gonna let masks get us down, right? That's right.
Concert of the year. We're really so grateful for all you've given to this, and parents, thank you for being here and bringing them and supporting us as well. A little bit of nuts and bolts, sixth and seventh graders, you have some exciting things going on tomorrow. Sixth graders, what's the first thing you're going to do tomorrow morning before you get in the car? Rapid test, take a picture, send it to the nurse, and then you get to go on your fun field trips tomorrow. Seventh graders, you have something fun going on tomorrow night. What is it?
The mixer.
The mixer is here, and if we can, we're going to keep it outside just to keep ourselves safe, so dress appropriately. We'll let you know by noon tomorrow if it's inside or outside. We're going to try for out as much as we can. Parents, thank you. If I would ask the parents and family members to just wait here or in the quad. Students, I'm going to run back and open the doors for you so you can get your stuff. Have a wonderful evening. Thanks for coming.